Welcome back to WagerTalk.com. I'm Marco D'Angelo, joined in studio with Brian Leonard. We're going to preview. This is your favorite video, guys. It's the video best bets of the week. Brian, we're going to start with you. You've got a baseball play on Friday night. You're going to take a look at Minnesota as they travel in to play Seattle. Pitching matchup is Pat Dean versus Felix Hernandez. What do you got on this one?
Yeah, Pat Dean just made his first major league start last time out. Hey, he looked decent. He doesn't have a lot of velocity on his fastball. He's probably more of a journeyman, not a higher pick for them, and not a lot of expectations. But this play is more of a play against King Felix, and it's traditional stats against the advanced stats here. Because you look at, I think he has like a 2.12 ERA on the season. His WHIP is basically about what it's always been. And people are going to look at that and say, wow, it's a regular King Felix. Yeah. But when you take a look at the advanced stats, and my first one I'm going to use is the BABIP, because I know you just love it when I say BABIP. But basically that's batted balls in play, batting average and balls in play. And, you know, for his career, he allows a 0.296, which is roughly what the league average is, a little bit under 300. This year, 241. So he's been very fortunate that these balls are being caught, that they're hitting in play. And his strikeouts per nine innings, career low 7.42. He just doesn't have the velocity as he has had in the past. And on the other side, his walks per nine, career high 3.95. So his control has not been anywhere near what it's been in the past. And his strikeout to walk ratio, 1.88. His career average, 3.34, almost twice as high. So when you get into these advanced stats, you see that even though King Felix has a great ERA, it's not the same King Felix.
And this is one of the things that we talked about a couple weeks ago on the videos, that the market, Vegas and the betting, the average player, they're slower to adjust when it's a big name or a good team heading south than they are whenever a team is, you know, or a pitcher's coming up and getting better. They don't want to believe that a star is starting to decline, and you can get value before the market adjusts. And obviously, anytime you see Hernandez on the mound for Seattle, you're going to be laying a price with him, especially at home. You're getting some value. And the Twins, you know, some might say that, you know, you got a big set to take Minnesota on the road because, you know, they're a team that's not played well. But this is a good situation where you're looking at value in long term. This is the type of play that you're going to take because you're always going to be getting a big price. And you don't have to win over 50% to be making a profit.
Yeah, we've talked in the past about the sharp books and the weaker books. Just take a look at what the sharp books are going to deal you on this game, and you're going to see it's going to be the lowest number on Key Felix. Take a look at Seattle, 43-62 at home, playing against a team with the worst record. King Felix at home, playing against a team with a lesser record. Look at Seattle, a home team, it's 19 games under 500. You know they were major favorites in most of those games, and they are playing a team with the worst record. So this has just got a huge ROI. I'm going to take Minnesota here.
All right. Well, for mine, I'm going to go to Friday as well. This is one of my favorite situational spots. We got Colorado is going to be returning home from a 9-game road trip. Now, most of the time when teams play a long road trip and it finishes up on a Thursday, they're going to schedule them a day game, especially when they're traveling time zones. You've got Colorado that plays Thursday. They play in Boston, not a day game, a night game. So now you got to finish up a night game in Boston, turn around, travel back to Colorado. You got the time zone difference, and they're going to be playing San Francisco, who has a day off on Thursday. Day offs are huge. You know, it lets you reset your bullpen and everything else. You know, everybody gets that day off. So you're going to have San Francisco lined up perfectly with whatever they need to do if they're in the game, late in the game. Now, they're throwing a pitcher that's Matt Cain. And this is a guy I know you did, I did. At the beginning of the season, we were making money going against him. He was pitching horrible, him and Jake Peavy for San Francisco. Matt Cain's turned it around. His last three starts, we'll go back in order, most recent, 6 innings, 1 run against the Cubs. The Cubs, for the first 6 weeks of the season, best team in baseball. 7 innings, 1 run at Arizona. Not an easy place to pitch in Arizona. 8 innings, 2 runs at home against Toronto. Toronto, known for that powerful lineup. The guy's been pitching good baseball. He's turned it around. He's going to be facing Eddie Butler on Friday. I just think it's a great spot. I think you're still looking at that big ERA from early in the season. He's pitching much better. Combine that with the scheduling situation that I like here. I got to make a play on San Francisco, and it doesn't hurt. they're playing some of the best ball in baseball right now. They're red hot.
They're playing great ball. I just don't like to play an erratic pitcher when he goes to Colorado. That's my only drawback on that. But, yeah, San Francisco's playing the much better ball right now. Colorado's a team I like to go against on the road. At home, they've been, they break even overall if you go back over the years. But, yeah, it's a situation that you rarely see traveling all the way from the East Coast in a night game. So I'm not as big on situations as you are in baseball, but I know this falls right up your alley.
All right, there you go. All right, guys, hey, if you want to save $10 this weekend, we'll give you a coupon in honor of the hottest team in the NBA, the Thunder. We're going to make the coupon code this week, Thunder and the number 10. Just type in Thunder, the number 10, enter it, check out in the coupon code section. You'll get $10 off that package. You might want to use that on the weekend all access. That'll bring that cost down to $59, giving you an even better deal. Check it out at wagertalk.com. Brian and I will be back with more videos here at Wager Talk.